What's up, everybody? Sam here. It's good to see you. How's everybody doing? Welcome to the, what is this, episode 12? 12th episode of Hunker in the Bunker, our final episode. Thank you for all of you that, if there's anybody that's been here for all 12, I will be handing out gold stars at the end of this episode, so please stick around in the chat afterwards. That was a joke. Pretty dry tonight, just gonna let y'all know. It's gonna be dry. Hope everyone's been hanging in there. Glad to see you, like I said again. Let's just kick it off. Got it easy. Cheers, everybody. Sipping on a little Modelo tonight. What are y'all drinking out there? Y'all got some beverages you're sipping on? Lord knows everybody needs it. Right, all right. What's up, Craig Youngblood? You're welcome for these shows. I thank y'all for tuning into these. I really appreciate it. These have been sanity for me. Just getting to at least play a little bit and just say a bunch of dumb stuff into a microphone. It's kind of what I do for a living, so it's good to get to do that a little bit. If y'all don't know Craig Youngblood, he's a phenomenal photographer. Him and his wife come out to shows, and they do really cool work. Western Soul Photography, I believe, is the name. Check that out. He's on Instagram and Facebook and all that stuff. Thank you.
this mountain, you know where I'm gonna go. Straight down the Mississippi River to the Gulf of Mexico, to Lake Louisiana, a little Bessie girl I once knew. She told me just to stop on by if there's anything she could do. Well, up on Cripple Creek, she sent me if I sprang a leak. She meant me, I don't have to speak. She'd have been me a drunkard's dream if I ever did see one. Well, that good luck had to stalk me to the racetrack, got to go. She bet on one horse to win, and I bet on another to show.
Think y'all can hear it, but we had a nice little train going by in the background. That made that song extra nice for me. Just trying to explain that to you, how much better it was here than it was where y'all are watching, because we had a train. So I'm not trying to flex or anything, but there is a train very close to here. It carries those, most of the time it's carrying those big old solar power, that's the wrong alternative energy, Sam. This is the wind turbines, which are like the size of like 6 18-wheelers. They're gigantic. It's crazy, those things just whizzing around the air. I'm not sure about it, man. I'm not sure about that wind energy or that solar energy. How can it produce as much as gelatinous dinosaur bones that we pump out of the earth? No way can power a twin turbine engine or a Corvette. Let's do Dopest Chose. Let's do Dopest Chose. This is the last Dopest Chose. We have coming to us this week, DP from Denton, because that's what your Twitter says. You don't have your name on there, because you're probably a smart person. Probably shouldn't be putting our names on stuff we do online, but you know, here I am with my name on all this. But right here we have this is a good quick nacho plate. These are some quick chows. You know, it's not a full plate. This is what I would call a half order, maybe a little bit bigger than a half order. But you will notice each chip is individually dressed perfectly. I do give it a few points for the sour cream guacamole plating. That's nice. Looks like he's got a Pacifico there with two limes, which I appreciate. I like to go pretty citrusy on the Mexican beer. Pacifico being a great one. I like the plating. You got a good smattering of chos there, DP, from Denton, Texas. I'm proud of you. I hope those chos did you well. Hope they gave you sustenance, maybe energy to go another round on Gears of War or whatever you're playing at the house. I don't know. Nachos seem like a thing that some gamers probably like. A little bit of a gamer myself. Been playing playing some stuffs. I'm kind of all over the map, though. Play Skyrim, really like Skyrim. And then I also like, I like a sport game. I like me an NBA 2K. I like to dunk on some people, if y'all don't know. I can't do that in real life, so it's super sweet to get to dunk on people. I also can't cast wizard spells or expel vampires from caves in real life, so that's also why I like Skyrim, is that kind of scratches that itch for me. Not really something you get to go out and test out, you know. All right. We got a tequila wine. Margaret. What is tequila? Are you drinking tequila wine? Whew. I don't know about that. Yikes. Rocket League. I haven't played Rocket League. Is Rocket League good? Seems like the kids love it. I might try it out. Who knows? Oh, we got some good drinks out there. We got a gin and tonic. We got some tequila wine. Someone's drinking a Napa cab. Dun, 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 dun. That's very fancy. Napa cab. Jack with a Coke back. That's my man. Topo Chico with lemon. That's what my mom's drinking. Good job, Mom. I like that. Everybody say hello to Mark behind the board. Mark, what's up, Mark? Mark's been doing this entire run. Y'all give it up for Mark. This is a weird thing that he's doing, and he's doing a hell of a job at it.
Christmas, but none of you gave a shit then. 300 $2, Herman got it on the stereo. Going out to the canyon, eating psychedelic mushrooms, staring at the fire, trying to make myself a plan. This world's so fast, sometimes it makes me dizzy, but I know that most of us just do the best we can. I never was one for big city traffic, driving through the desert in the buildings made of sand. So let's call this a chorus. You know I'm so tired of writing 3 songs a day, how could anybody care? Gonna make it big, I'm going out to California. Gonna buy me a motorcycle and make a life out there. Says she's going to Colorado, going to get her motorcycle. We believe if she wouldn't say it all the time.
Hey, there's a little Colorado for you. My buddy TC sent me a really cute video of his baby jamming out to Colorado today, and it was a really much needed positive video. It's pretty cute. I also got sent a video to our band Twitter the other day of a little kid in his car seat in the back, and he knows all the words to Queso Blanco, which is crazy because on any given night, I might not know all the words to Queso Blanco. So that was pretty cool. Always love seeing, kids are dope, dude. They're hilarious. I don't have any, just to be clear. They seem like a lot of work. A lot, you know. I don't understand you people that get outnumbered too, that have more than two of them. You know, once you get outnumbered, what do you do? There's too many of them. Thank y'all again so much. I'm gonna point to the Venmo down here below me, Venmo and PayPal for Maine at Southside. The money, of course, money going to people at Maine at Southside that have been quarantined now. What is this, 13 weeks, you know, that we've had to be shut down like this, and that's really hard for somebody. Can you imagine going without work for 13 weeks? That's not something you really plan out. It's also not something, I know for me, I have the money to plan out. So all the donations y'all have made have been extremely generous, and we really appreciate it. You know, of course, money also going to other musicians and service workers in the Fort Worth area. Y'all have been wonderful about that. This is the last one. I won't bother you for money anymore after this week. I mean, I might, just not on this platform. But really do appreciate that. Thank y'all so much. Sorry, I'm not like all there today. I didn't sleep. Haven't slept. Stayed up all night like watching all the live feeds and stuff like that of everything that went on. And I kind of want to be careful what I say here. But I'm not going to... The horrible stuff that went on, and I've been really bothered also by the response to people responding to the looting, because the issue at hand here is the murder of an innocent person. And if you watch how the narrative changes quickly to looting, because that's what we want to do, we want to talk about the response and not what created the response. But what we're watching with all these protests, and I think they're gonna absolutely keep going on, What you're watching is the history of America. This is what we've always done. And then the people, you know, I don't want to address the looting too much because I think it's focusing on the wrong issue. But the people that are angry about that, I don't think you understand. Like, I don't know. Maybe you're thinking down the wrong train of thought, but I know I have too. But if you look at the history of black people in the United States, since like the 1600s, there's been slaves here. And, you know, Civil War happens, right? And they're supposedly African Americans are emancipated in the South. And they were free for a little less than a decade, actually, because right after that, the North-South Compact happened, and basically allowing the South to do whatever they want and have the Northern troops pull out of the Southern states. And so because they couldn't have slaves anymore, but they were allowed to kind of do whatever they wanted to do, the Southern states started making black lives illegal. So they could no longer enslave them, but they could make things that they did illegal, or what they thought they did, and accuse them of things. So since the Emancipation Proclamation, you get maybe less than a decade out of it before you're going back to where now they've created a new assault on you, which is making your lives illegal. And that has gone on since then. And what they found out whenever they made black lives illegal is that they can incarcerate them. And you're talking about the South after Reconstruction that is basically in shambles after the Civil War because their workforce was decimated. Well, now they have, in their eyes, a better workforce because when you have slaves, you have to keep them alive and you have to pay for them and you have to pay for them to eat. When you have black people that you have arrested, the state pays for it. So now they have free labor. We just created another way to entrap people, and now they have free labor. And there's been ways we reinvent that, and we've been reinventing that and doing it for hundreds of years. It's what, 400 plus years that we've been doing this. The war on drugs, that's a war on black people. So if you don't understand why they're looting, think about that. Think about, you know, you want them to go a peaceful route. They've tried that. You know? They've tried that before. Once you try everything the route that you're told you're supposed to try it and none of it works, what are you going to do? That's my high horse for that tonight.
Tomorrow, I'll be on my
It's a Harry Nilsson song for you. I don't know why I talk so quiet when I'm in this bunker thing. It's like my bunker voice. I'm not having to talk over a bunch of y'all idiots out there watching me. I can't hear y'all, so it's great. It's always challenging. That's actually why, fun note, that's why I started, that's why David and I decided to start Quaker City Night Hawks. We were playing duo shows all over Fort Worth, and we were sick of everybody talking over us. So I was like, I'll figure that out real quick. I'll buy the loudest 1970s PV's amps and dare y'all to talk over me. Worked out pretty well. I've enjoyed the entire run so far. I can't wait to record again. Quaker City will be recording again very soon, as soon as we can figure out the best way to get that done safely, but more importantly, actually, no, safety is important. I was about to do the safety third thing. But we want to make it sound good, but we also want to be safe while we're doing it. It's kind of hard to think of any sort of normalcy returning in the next couple months. I don't even know what's going on as we speak right now. I think that we're in for another long night tonight. I think we're in for quite a few long nights. Let's do, that's heavy. I don't like talking about that. Karen, I'm gonna miss doing these Friday nights too. These have been fun. I like all the people up here. Oh, I would like to talk about Maine at Southside is, they're going to start reopening soon. Was it June 5th, I believe? Let me get confirmation. Higgs is probably in the chat. He can help. I think it's June 5th. But they're going to start doing shows at 25% capacity. And these people are very, very serious. I've been working with these people the entire length of this. They're very serious about safety. And they are extremely cautionary, and they want to provide a good experience for you. But it will be at 25% capacity. I believe you will have to buy tickets in advance. And once they're at 25%, it'll be called a sellout. If there's walk-in space, I think you'll be allowed in. But once they hit that cap, that's it. So when you see a show come up for Mass and you want to go, you better grab the ticket quick, because you're going to need to be able to get there. And it's going to be seated, all right? Be seated shows, so you'll be able to maintain social distancing. And I believe they'll have people bringing drinks and stuff like that, too. So they'll be bringing your drinks so you don't order at the bar. So I'm really happy for them. I can't thank them enough for letting me do this, for letting me meander on for 12 weeks. 13 weeks, however long we've been doing this. Just say whatever is on my mind. Probably, hopefully, I didn't get him in trouble or anything with my too much politics. Too much politics! Yeah, well, there's too much of a lot of crap right now, so we're going to talk about what I want. This is my live stream, damn it. But, yeah, sorry. Thank you to all them. Thanks to Mark, you know, I've been back here engineering the entire time. Y'all got any requests you want to hear? I'm kind of feeling requesty. Yeah, everybody got quiet. I bummed everybody out. I'm sorry. Yeah, we can do a couple more here. What do y'all? If y'all don't pick something, I'm going to pick something. I think you're really in for it. What? Oh, yeah, let's do that. Here's Willin. I think it's a story about Will Smith. Will Smith from the 90s, though. Not still jacked dad Will Smith. Out on the road lately.
my pretty Alice in every headlight. Alice, Dallas, Alice. Now I've been from Tucson to Dunkerque to Hatcher, Peter, Tom, and Paul. Driven every kind of rig that's ever been made. Driven the back roads so I wouldn't get away. If you give me a wing, white and white, show me a sign.
That's a little fee tune right there. Willin'. Right. Knocked that thing out of tune on that one. Not like I was playing hard. What's the deal? It's these big old hand fists that I'm playing with. I did make some nachos this week. I forgot to tell y'all. I didn't bring the picture with me. Because I made them at 2:30 in the morning. I was ashamed. I ate them standing up at the kitchen table like a real cool dude. That's a slick move right there where you just hover and just doing the, when you get it, you know, you get it in your mouth because you just got out of the boiler. You're like, just wait, you idiot. Like, just wait like 45 seconds and it'll be cooled off. You're like, no, I gotta get that. Gotta get at that. I did add a black bean. I did like a refried black bean layer on like a white corn tortilla chip. Woo. Just with a little cheese. And didn't go topping crazy on this one. Just did some, a little bit of onion, a little bit of jalapeno. No meat this time. Just a veggie cho there, which is a fine cho. I mean, the original cho was a veggie cho. So you're getting fancy when you're putting the protein on it. I mean, I guess beans are protein too, but when you're putting the meat on it, that's a That's a sit-down show. You don't eat that one standing up at the kitchen table or over the sink. I got a like a small apartment, so like the kitchen and the kitchen table are very, very close to each other, sink, so you kind of run to one the other. If you get a little topping spillage, clean that up too before you go to bed. You're going to get yelled at if you leave them on the floor. Don't leave cho toppings on the floor, or you will be in trouble the next day. I 100% guarantee it. Don't want that. Alrighty. I was just like the dad when they're ready to go, just like checking all my pockets.
Yep. We're ready to get out of here.
Alright. All right, let's do one more. No, let's go. Let's go a couple more. I've been talking a lot tonight. It just seems like I've been here a while, but I haven't. I've just been blathering on. Let's do something fun. Big old noise right there. For those of you keeping score at home, this song is in C sharp. I know y'all are writing it down. That's one thing I didn't even really think of when we started these, was like, these are going to be recorded and permanent. I was like, oh! Thought I was just throwing some stuff out there in the dark, never to be seen again, like a live show or something. That's why I like that so much. I have not watched any. I can't watch them. I have not gone back and watched a one. I just can't do it. I can't do it. I know. I know I'm going to make fun of myself for everything. So, you know what? Why do that to yourself? You know? If there's something that makes you feel weird, just avoid it at all costs. Don't ever confront it. Just let that ride. Oh my goodness. This song is not in C sharp. This is not in C sharp. I apologize. There's a lot of people keeping score at home that are mad. This song's in B.
Be sure. else shall give it away. Oh, what if my time is coming? I'd rather now pick a new name. Said I can make you love it, but I can't make you give it away. Said I can make you love it, but I can't make you give it away.
Hey, there's a little Quaker City Night Hawks song for you. That is off our last album. That was a fun one to record. We did that in Niles City. That song specifically was fun to record. I've enjoyed that one. A little sexy time. You get four of the least sexy guys playing some sexy music. No, we're all funny. That's sexy, right? It's funny. Funny is sexy, I hope. I think, yeah. I mean, I've been leaning hard on it. So, what's crazy is it's not that funny. So, it's like, you know, kind of the difficult there. Well, here's one last cheers on this. Everybody, hold them up. Mom, you can cheers your topo, it'll clink. Got bubbles. Thank y'all so much. Please be safe. I'm gonna do one more after this, but cheers to y'all, and thank you for watching these. Thank you for donating money, and thank you to all that was involved. Been a hell of a run. I love every one of you. Gonna close it out how we normally close it out. Shout out to all of our dopest show winners. Keep making them. Keep sending me pictures. I like it. Gives me something to do. Makes me feel like we connect.
Dusty, old, and gray. Don't leave. in the twilight. 'Cause twilight is the loneliest time of day. Take the darkness on storms in the skies. We all got certain trials burning up inside, and you only hurt yourself. You don't know what you're doing, trying to make it all alone. Who you think you're fooling? So don't hear me, none and I can hold on. Nothing that I can give away. Don't leave me alone in the twilight. It's twilight.
Thank y'all so much. Thanks for all this. Y'all be safe. Love you.